For some time now, my favourite club in my bag has been the TaylorMade P790 UDI. But now there's a couple of new kids on the block. Let's do it, and let's do it now. Not used to this. I don't know how to act, don't know how to adapt to this situation. Not used to this, no I'm not, but better let myself. Hi everyone, James Robinson here. Guys, first things first, guys, if you are new to the channel, I'd like to warmly welcome you to the channel. And if you're not new to the channel, welcome back to the channel. Guys, if you are new to the channel, make sure you do take 1 second to hit that subscribe button below. That way, you won't miss any of the great golf-related content I bring to you guys every single day. In today's video, this is going to be cool. Also, guys, make sure if you haven't checked out the giveaway for the Cobra Speed Zone Camo Driver, make sure you get involved in that. I'll link that video here now. That's quite a cool little subplot to this video. I filmed that just now, just today. Really enjoyed it. So if you want that, you could be in with a chance of winning it. But today's video, guys, before we get properly into this video, do me a favor and hit those comments below. Which club would you have in the bag? Would you go TaylorMade Sim DHY? Would you go P790 UDI? Or would you go New Sim UDI? Guys, let me know. Today's video is all about, my favorite club for a long time has been this TaylorMade P790 UDI. For me, it's perfect for what I want. It's a great driving iron. If I hit it, to be honest, it almost goes as far as my driver. I've hit a couple of shots with it here already. And that's another one. That's just an absolute bullet, and that's on the line as well. So we're not gonna spend too much time dwelling on that. We're gonna look to the future. We're gonna look for the TaylorMade Sim UDI and Sim DHY. UDI, DHY. And there's a big difference to these, as you can well imagine. So we're gonna test them both out. We're gonna see exactly how different they are to the TaylorMade P790 UDI. Don't know why I said TaylorMade, because these are all TaylorMade. These have taken the place of the TaylorMade Gapper. So we have the Gapper Low, the Gapper Mid, the Gapper High. They're designed to be the difference between your longest playable iron and your shortest wood. So if you have a 5 wood, if you have a 4 iron, you'd go a Gapper in between. Not important. But these two look totally different, even to the TaylorMade P790 UDI, because the Sim UDI, I actually played a few holes with this when we were down south, if you remember, and I like it. But comparing it to my kind of baby, as it were, the P790, it just looks that bit thicker. It looks almost more like, remember the Gapper Mid, and it's not quite the Gapper Mid, but you can see a little bit behind the blade. It's a bit of a thicker top line, looks a bit more forgiving. There's more offset. So we're gonna compare them and see if this could replace, I mean, we've had some good times, some real good times. We'll see. So can it replace it? Does it go better? Does it go further? Does it go higher? Does it spin less? Does it spin more? That was a bad strike to start with, and that's a good result. This definitely gives you more confidence if you're not playing amazingly well. Just look at those top lines there. We've got the new Sim UDI on the right here, and the P790 UDI on the left, and you can see that there's a thicker top line. You can definitely see that there's a little bit more CG placed back, so it shouldn't be as low a spin as the P790, and there's actually a little bit more offset, which to me, I don't want offset on it. I sounded like Foxy then. I don't want offset on it because that makes it go left for me. Although that last one went right. Let's commit to one. I've hit that good. I've hit that really good. Leaking right again. Sub 2000 spin. And it hasn't lost the feel that attracted me to the P790, which for me is vitally important. They do feel very, very good. Yes, they're full of technology, the hollow body construction, they've got speed phone in, they've got the through pocket speed slot, which gives you a bit more ball speed on miss hits and things like that. The tech is still there, but you still get the feel. That's so important when you absolutely nail one, it's unbelievable. That's gotta be left, has it? No? Bottomy one. That's where you're quite happy that you do get the forgiveness there. So we're gonna hit 6 shots with each. I've already hit 6 with the P790. To be honest, I think it's very, very clever what TaylorMade have done, because obviously the P790 is still a very strong range for TaylorMade, and it will continue to be a strong range because people love them. So you wouldn't take out the P790 UDI because it's like the golden, not the golden goose, but it's just there, isn't it? So if you look at these three now, actually, we have the P790 UDI, the Sim UDI, and the Sim DHY. all a little bit different. So do you need, I don't know. It's a strange one in that, yes, we've lost the Gappa range, but then have we lost the Gappa range? Have we got it in a bit more of a kind of sellable form? Because it was always a bit weird, the Gappa range, I thought, with the color scheme. And I've hit that so hard and it's gone so far right. Four right! I almost wonder, not even four left, I almost wonder there if because of the offset, I'm like not wanting to hit it left. All these shots have gone right. Like all of them, like all four of them. See if we can play a bit of a draw. Trying, still not amazing. Looking down at it, it's not really my cup of tea, this. It definitely wouldn't. And I thought this as soon as I took it out on the golf course when we were down at Poole at Bournemouth in Dorset. It definitely has the shelf appeal with it having the Sim name, which is quite a strong name now, isn't it? Because people are loving the drivers, the fairways, especially the hybrid. I think people will look at it. Again, I wasn't sure about the Gappa range with it being the green and the black, and it didn't match anything. The head covers didn't match anything. The clubs didn't match anything. And they kind of scratched off as well. The back of them, do you remember the back of them? These are better. These feel like better build quality. They feel like, to be honest, better clubs. And they just feel a little bit more kind of thoughtful, thought through. Feel like people have actually thought about them. Right, last one with the Sim UDI. Then we'll go DHY. DHY. Oh, you're always going to say you're not going to put it in the bag and then you hit that. That was gorgeous. That was really nice. Back in there you go. Not for good. So moving out of the UDI family and moving into the DHY family, you'll see immediately the biggest difference is the huge sole here. So it looks immediately way more forgiving. It looks immediately way more confidence building if you don't want to see those kind of stinger shots, if you don't want to see those uber low spin shots. But it also comes with more options. You can get this in a 2, 3, 4 and 5 iron, whereas with the P790 UDI you can only get it in 2 iron. With the Sim UDI you can only get that in 2 and 3 iron, and with the rescues you can go 2 right through to 7. So it's kind of a big variance for everyone. Looking down at this, definitely not my cup of tea, unless I was playing a real long golf course where I had to get the ball airborne, I had to get it to land soft. It's not going to be your typical open style course, it's going to be more maybe a US Open style course. So this should launch a little bit higher. TaylorMade say 3-2-1 launch. So we'll go with that. It's another Healy one, but I mean, it's definitely got something there. And I think this will appeal to more your kind of mid handicap players. It will appeal to you guys who maybe don't want to hit a 5-iron, don't want to hit a 4-iron. 2-iron wise, it looks like it's got more loft on it, but that's only because you can see such a chunk behind it. Come on, let's get a draw going. I've hit that good. I've hit that really good. And that's just soaring nicely, spinning at 3,000, which is, I mean, it's just ideal what you'd want for this. Looking down at it, I don't feel like it's got as much offset as the Sim UDI, which is a strange one. I think it probably has got the same amount, but still jam-packed with that hollow body core, with the speed foam, with the ICT, with the weight in the bottom. You'll see that with the DHY as opposed to the UDI, the weighting is on the bottom as opposed to on the back. That gives it a little bit more forgiveness, but you can still get that kind of mid-launch instead of a high launch. Oh, I hit that really good. Stop hitting it right, though. That's a long way, though. I mean, that's usually my 3-wood numbers. 250 is usually a 3-wood for me, and I'm hitting these a long way. So I'd probably rein it in a little bit, but then absolutely nailed my P790 UDI as well. So, you know, I'm enjoying this. I'm losing track of how many I've hit. I mean, look at that. It can't go in the bag, can it? Look at that. I'm all right saying this is for mid-handicappers, but check that out for a ball flight and those for numbers. And it does say on the website, if you do have a look at the differences between the UDI and the DHY, it does give you different launches. And I think if you did put the P790 in there, that would be the lowest of the launch. And we will have a look at that when I've hit two more with this. Ah, I've gone after that one. That wasn't very good. I apologise for that. One more. One more. I've gone after that. Still in there though, isn't it? Definitely so much more real estate behind this than the others. I've nearly missed that one as well. This is definitely the most forgiving. I could tell there that I was getting a little bit lazy with the swings. I was like, oh, this is, I can go after this one. And obviously a golf swing doesn't always react how you would like it to. Right, that's 6 shots hit with all of these clubs. I'll show you the P79 UDI swings. You don't need to see all those. What's the big difference? For me, initially, the big difference is the visuals. If you want something that looks sleek, looks slim, I still go with the P790 UDI. I'm going to tell you now, that's going to stay in my bag just because I absolutely love it. After that, it's the offset that does it for me. It doesn't fill me with confidence. I'm not going to snap hook it because that's obviously my bad shot, even though I've not hit any here. So maybe it's sort of doing what it says it does do in the forgiveness factor. Let's compare them and have a look. So dispersion and trajectory, as we'll look at the UDI to start with. A couple of real knuckleballs in there. One big high draw, which I was quite happy with. Overall, over like kind of 240, 250 yards, I'm happy with that dispersion as well. Big thing for me is the none here, which we all know I've been trying to work on. Now we'll go sim UDI, and I don't know if the offset was putting me off a little bit. I mean, the trajectory wise, it is definitely higher on average, isn't it? Just not sure. I mean, the green's over here, James. It's not there. What about the DHY? So the DHY for me, very similar to the UDI. And again, I honestly don't know. I feel like I've been swinging pretty consistent throughout this whole test. And actually that's not gone as high as I would have expected for the DHY there. What about the numbers? So look at the numbers on average. These are 6 shots each, maybe 7 with the UDI actually. And very close. The DHY, definitely the most forgiving, as I said. And you can see that that's gone 7 yards further than my own P790 UDI, which I'm using. Very, very similar numbers with those bottom two, so the sim UDI and the P790 UDI. Spin rates, all pretty similar. That's obviously massively dependent on strike. 3000 for the sim UDI, 28 for the sim DHY, and 27 for the P790 UDI. Ball speeds, all again in that kind of ballpark, depending on how I've hit it. Interestingly, generating quite a bit more club head speed with the sim UDI than my P790 UDI. So if we look at, I'm going to delve right into all of them. So the sim DHY, the best shot was a 259, 250 carry, club speed 98.3, ball speed 153, spinning at 2.5, would be really happy with that. The P790 UDI, the longest one I know, was like 260 there, pitching at 249, so a little bit more run out. Club head speed 96, ball speed 142, spinning at 21. That first one, 19 spin, that was a knuckleball, a little bit of a stinger for you there. What about the last one, the sim UDI? So the best shot with the sim UDI was 252. It was the last one there. Club head speed 95, producing a ball speed of 142, spinning at 3.2. So interestingly for me there, I can hear you all saying, well, sure, you'd put the DHY in the bag. And you know what? I could put it in the bag, but I'd have to take something out. I'd have to maybe drop a wedge. Because for me, I love hitting the P790 UDI off the tee. Whenever you ask anyone who's played with me recently, I've absolutely asked Gaz, asked Foxy, I've been nailing it. Even at the driving range, I've just... I mean, not that way, but like just straightforward, really enjoying it. So I'm not going to play around with that because I know that on the golf course, it does really well. The DHY, I would have more for really long par threes if I'm trying to get the ball really kind of high. I know it didn't show it went high, but it felt like it did. It felt more forgiving. It felt like something which, if you have a number you're trying to hit, 246, that would be the club that you're going to hit. But for me, I feel like I can make do with the P790 for those shots because they're so rare. I might have one or two of those around where I'm going to use it off 6 or 7 tees, probably, especially this time of year where it's a little bit drier. So different clubs, totally different clubs, definitely worth trying out if you're looking for something like that. I prefer them to hybrids, definitely prefer them to hybrids because I feel like I can manufacture something a little bit more. Guys, thank you so much for watching. Really hope you've enjoyed that. If you have, hit that subscribe button below if you're yet to do so. Leave us a like if you enjoyed that video. Comment below which one would you use. And also, guys, if you do want to see, I mentioned this at the beginning of the video, I'm going to be drawing this in a couple of weeks, so make sure you're in the hat for that. And apart from that, guys, I'll just really look forward to seeing you all tomorrow. Bye.